Good morning. I am hoping you can hear me okay. It is Tuesday. I hope you have some tacos lined up. You're gonna be maybe a little hungry after this. I hope that you can hear me okay because I'm trying the AirPod speakers, headphones. And I just hope that it works, and we'll find out afterwards. I haven't had a chance to test them. But I have several books in front of me that I just wanna kind of share with you. This one, it says One Good Deed a Day. And I've had this one for years. Every once in a while, I just like to open up a page, and then it says, for today's good deed, ask someone what's bothering her and then listen. So that's going to be my one good deed today. And then if anything is even bothering them. But sometimes there's always something that people don't want to underline, talk about. And also, I've been working a lot on trying to shift my ways back into just being like connected with myself, connected with my soul, as cliche as that sounds, just being very connected with being myself again, however that looks. And sometimes I feel like I kind of tend to get a little too busy and then forget to reconnect. And I'm just going to read this quote. It says, when we recognize the divine presence everywhere, then we know that it responds to us and that there is a law of God, a law of love forever giving of itself to us. So this law of love ties back into, I want to bring it back up, when we are in presence of others, when we go to a yoga studio, a practice at the park. I want to tie back into non-judgment and non-expectations. And I want to remind everybody that when we set foot on our mats, I like to call it my universe. And this mat is for the next 55 minutes, my universe. And I want to bring that up because that means that we are loving ourselves, and in so doing, we are loving others. So I want to, with that intention, bring it back to our heart centers, our palms meet one another, maybe close our gaze or keep a soft gaze, finding a comfortable seated sukhasana, listening to the way we show up in our breath without changing it or shifting it, not quite yet. I really appreciate you all being here truly for yourselves. I appreciate you connecting with me as a yoga certified instructor and as a person. I appreciate all your direct messages and all your comments and likes on the things I share with you on a day-to-day basis. And I invite you to continue to engage with me. Maybe share with friends who are having low back pain. Those that want to be more flexible, and those that want to see about the wrists and fingertips, as these are some things that we're going to work on today, and this would be a class to share with friends on those specific subjects or in general as a yoga as a whole. As you continue to arrive and notice how you are showing up to your mat today, are feeling a little bit tight on the shoulders, go ahead and relax your shoulders. Maybe untangle that jaw grip. And find yourself shifting into this place as you listen to the birds sing. Maybe you have some Zen music going on at home. Invite you to press your palms against one another and really feel that connection of yourself from one hand to the other as you interlace and exchange energy. The heat radiating to each other. Without heat, we don't know cold. Without cold, we underestimate heat. Drawing the breath through your nose into your low belly. Filling up all four corners as you exhale your belly. Drawing that belly button back towards your spine as you literally tuck it in, suck it in. Relax the shoulders once again. Inhale through your nose into your low belly. As you exhale your belly back towards your spine, begin to lift the torso just slightly, keeping the shoulders relaxed. Inhale through your nose into your low belly. Lifting the torso or keeping it lifted. Reaching a long neck, tucking your chin just slightly as you reach through the crown of your head up toward the sky. Take another inhale through your nose, into your low belly and up the lower ribs. Giving your organs space to breathe and fully express themselves into their shape of living. So exhale, let it go. Let go of that to-do list, bring it back. Inhale through your nose, into your low belly, up the lower ribs. Exhale the ribs as you hug your organs, belly towards spine, keeping your torso lifted off of your hips. On your following inhale, inflate the belly, the ribs, and the chest. Feeling tall, keeping the chin slightly tucked. Exhale the chest, ribs, and then belly button back towards your spine. Taking another inhale through your nose. As you continue to three-part breathe, simply shift your attention and awareness back to here. Feeling every whimpse of wind that flies by. Listening to the sound of your breath as you really tune in to the space, back into this moment, as your thoughts begin to drift away, really back in. Following exhale, followed by an inhale, we're going to prepare our thoughts to om together. We're going to take three oms, and we're going to begin with an exhale. We're going to take an inhale, fully exhale, and then we're going to inhale. So on the second inhale, so go ahead and go ahead and take one more exhale. I lied. Sitting in space as you feel the vibration in your sternum, feeling as your breath travels in and then out. Finding this present moment to be at peace. Distractions, and if there are, drawing yourself back to the space. Placing your palms or hands over your eyes. Take a couple of blinks with your eyes closed. Begin to peek through your fingertips. Allowing your hands to begin to fall back to your knees as your eyes are open. And now go ahead and meet me in on your backs. Removing anything from underneath your sit bones. So go ahead and meet me on your backs with a long neck. Your chin is slightly tucked. Soles of your feet come near your hip bones. And then go ahead and lift both of your legs up. And then like Barbie feet, you know, like the Barbie dolls, how they kind of are always kicking through the balls of the feet. Go ahead and do Barbie toes. And then allow your toes to point towards you. Go ahead and point your toes all the way, arching the soles of your feet. If you cramp a little bit, lift right through it. It feels amazing in the oddest of ways. Go ahead and point through your index toes. Really, really, really arch the soles of your feet. And then go ahead and point your toes towards you. Go ahead and see if you can bring those the pinky toes towards you. Now the big mount toes, pigeon toe there. And then go ahead and go back to your Barbie feet. Place your hands by your sides right here, palms connected with the earth. And then go ahead and drop your right leg down. Bring it up. Drop your left leg down about an inch off the floor. Bring it back up. Barbie toes, right leg down, bring it up. Left leg down, bring it up. Awesome. Let's take that one more time. Right leg down, bring it up. and then left leg down, bring it back up. Now go ahead and see if you can just about find neutral feet, and then bring your toes to be fitted together like a glove, like if they're being saran wrapped, but without losing and crunching their shape. And then just go ahead and admire your big toes. Now your index toes. Take a look at your middle toes. And then go ahead and gaze at your ring toes. And lastly, your pinky toes. Go ahead and bring your hands up with your legs, and then go ahead and see that your whole back is fully in contact with the earth. Draw your belly button back towards your spine. So you have a long spine right now, as best as possible. Press the sky away from your wrists. Go ahead and grab some fists and then arch your toes. Now go ahead and point both forward and then both back, keeping your toes pointed. And then lean them forward with the fists and the arches of the feet, and then bring it back. Now, if it's available to you, go ahead and grab your big mount toes, and then just go ahead and bring them in towards you, like your legs, kicking through your heels. Awesome. And let that go. If you're not able to reach, you can always use a strap, your handy dandy strap, you guys. Placing it around the balls of your feet and then bringing it in. Voila. All right, and then what I would like for you to do is to bring the soles of your feet back to the earth. We're just lubricating the joints right now. Place your left ankle over your right thigh and then extend the right leg over above you. And then go ahead and bend the right leg as you bring your legs toward your chest, grabbing your foot with your right hand, and then placing your left hand to open that left knee away from you as it opens up the left side of your hip. Bring it in towards your heart. If available to you, you can interlace your hands through the hoop and then behind your thigh, and then bring it in. Take an inhale and an exhale. And go ahead and extend the legs over above you. Go ahead and go back to your Barbie toes, hands connecting with the earth by your sides. And then go ahead and release the right leg down, bring it up. Left leg down, bring it up. Right leg down, bring it up. Left leg. One more time. Right leg. Left leg. Tap it and back up. Release the soles of your feet on the mat as you step your right ankle over your left knee or thigh. Extending the left leg over above us, Barbie toes. And then as you bend your leg, grab the foot with the left hand, and then with your right hand, press that knee away from you. If it hurts you guys, don't push too hard. You don't want it to strain the knee. You are opening the right hip on this area right here. And then if available to you, you can interlace through the hoop of your legs behind your thigh and bring it in to just a little bit more here. I'm kind of using my elbow to press this knee away from me. Take a full round of breath. And then go ahead and bring it back up. Both of your legs. Go ahead and arch the toes, point the toes, arch the soles of your foot or feet. And bring it up. Now go ahead and meet me onto your belly. See that your pelvis bone, pelvic bone, is in full contact with the earth, and I'm lifting my torso and I'm resetting it down. And then I'm going to bring my hands just below my shoulders by my chest, bringing my legs together. Heels meet one another. And then we're going to go ahead and take this three rounds as we inhale, bring your chest up, draw your elbows towards your ribs, lift a little bit higher, and exhale, bring it down, rest your forehead onto the mat, go ahead and bring it back up, heels together, looking ahead of you as you inhale, lift it no higher than your belly button, and then exhale, bring it down. Taking it one more time, engaging the back muscles that wrap around your low back. Go ahead and inhale, look ahead of you. Keep inhaling, bring it, rise it a little bit higher. Draw those elbows and heels together, and then exhale, bring it down. Go ahead and press through your hands and bring yourself down to a child's pose. This is a resting pose. You can come back to it at any time. As you roll through a tabletop, your wrists are below your shoulders and your hips are above your knees. Go ahead and do some cat-cow rounds with me as you inhale, drop the belly. And then exhale, curl the back. Inhale as you drop the belly. And then exhale, curl your back, chin to chest. Maybe do some barrel rolls. You're going in circular motions. Go ahead and inhale, drop the belly. And as you round your back, go ahead and come back with it. Take that one way one more time. As you come back to a neutral spine, go ahead and bend your elbows, lead with your heart, come forward and down. Inhale as you swoop up through a cobra, draw the shoulders back, heels toward midline. Exhale, come back to a child's pose. Inhale, come back through a tabletop, and then go ahead and drop the belly. Inhale as you look up, and then we're going to go ahead and take it the other way as we exhale. Whatever opposite side you hadn't gone last time, go ahead and take it as you drop the belly. Exhale, curl your back, go around in a circle with your whole body. One more time. And go ahead and curl your toes under, sit back on your heels, and then go ahead and just lean back slightly. Come back through a tabletop. Curl, keeping your toes curled under, go ahead and lift your knees about an inch or two off the ground. Go ahead and look at your knees and then release them down. Just creating a little bit of heat here. Spread your fingers nice and wide. Middle fingers are facing forward. Bring your shoulders above your wrists. Curl your toes under and then press up through a top of a plank. Belly towards spine. as you engage your thighs, lifting the kneecaps towards your hips. Go ahead and bend deep at your knees as you begin to press your shoulders away from the earth, rolling your shoulders out, and then beginning to lengthen through the legs behind you. Belly towards spine, chest toward thighs, hips toward the sky. Relax the head. Take an exhale. Go ahead and inhale your right leg up for a three-legged dog. Exhale, bring it in toward your heart center as you round your back. Inhale, extend it behind you. Exhale toward your heart center. And last time, inhale behind you. Go ahead and open that hip over to the left side body. You can do some circular motions with your legs if you'd like. And then go ahead and step it through. Release your foot onto the mat in between your hands slightly. Release the left knee down, top of your foot comes on the mat. Pressing through the tops of your back toes, right leg's at a 90 degree angle. So go ahead and fix that if you need to. Placing your hands on your hips, holding them there for support as you inhale, lift your torso, and then begin to sink your hips forward. Go ahead and open your arms out to goddess pose, gazing up slightly, and then exhale, bring it back down. Extend the front leg, keeping your foot, the sole of your foot, connected with the earth. Feeling a stretch down the front side of your shins as you exhale even deeper. Go ahead and bring your toes toward you as you shift your hips back behind you. And go ahead and walk your hands about a foot back. And then go ahead and bend your knee, bring it forward. Planting your left hand inside of your left foot. Go ahead and bring your right hand over up for the sky or just on your low back. Go ahead and circle that all the way back. And normal, planting both of your hands what they would be about beneath your shoulders, step your right foot back, top of a plank, belly towards your spine, and then go ahead and sink your knees deep, pressing your shoulders away from the earth, roll your shoulders out, and then begin to lengthen through the legs as your belly button meets your spine, chest toward thighs, hips toward the sky. Keep pressing your shoulders away from the earth, keeping them rotating outward. Relax the neck. On your following inhale, lift your left leg up. Three-legged dog as you exhale, bring it in toward your chest. Inhale, extend it out. And then exhale it in toward your chest. Last time. Inhale, three-legged dog. And then exhale, and then open it up toward your right side body, maybe doing some circular motions here. Then go ahead and exhale as you step it through. Release your back knee down, top of your foot comes onto the mat, bringing your hands to your hips, and then adjusting that your front leg is at a 90 degree angle, so the ankle is below the knee. Keep Keeping a hold of your hips, go ahead and begin to sink them forward just slightly. And if available to you, you can open your hands out to goddess pose, opening up your chest, maybe gazing just up slightly, opening yourself up to the law of love. And then exhale, bring it back down. Keeping the sole of your foot connected with your mat, go ahead and extend through your front leg. And then ever so gently bringing the toes with you as you roll onto the back of your heel. Take a breath here. And following, inhale, bend at the knee. Curl your back toes under, pressing your hands onto the mat as you step that foot back top of a plank. Release your knees onto the earth, bending your elbows, tucking them toward your ribs. Lead with your heart, come forward and down. Tops of your feet are on the mat. Inhale up for cobra, and then exhale for child's pose. Inhale up through your tabletop. Curl your toes under top of a plank as you rotate your heels over to the right side. Bring your left hand over by you. Lift the hips a little bit higher. And exhale, you can open your left arm up toward the sky. We're gonna exhale, bring it in below us. Inhale it back up. Exhale, curl it in. Inhale it up, last one. Exhale, curl it in. And then inhale, bring it up. Go ahead and release that arm down on the mat. Release the knees onto the earth. Bend your elbows, bring it forward and down. Tops of your feet are on the mat. Inhale up for cobra. Exhale through your child's pose. Inhale up through tabletop. Curl your toes under. Rotate them over to the left. And then bring your right hand over by your side. Lift the hip a little bit higher and then open the right arm up. Exhale, curl it in one. Inhale, extend. Exhale, two. Inhale, extend, last one. Exhale. And then go ahead, inhale. Release it down. Go ahead and open your knees wide, release them down onto the earth. Sink your hips towards your heels. Open your arms in front of you, walk them a little bit further. Drawing your chest in toward the earth as you stretch the shoulders. As you lengthen through the spine. Giving your wrists a break. And go ahead and come up, looking up at your hands, walk yourself back to a hero sitting pose. You can stay here if it's comfortable, or you can bring your knees a little bit closer together. Whatever is comfortable, you guys. And then go ahead and bring the knuckles of your fingers to just the first little bit of nail part. And then go ahead and grip them like you would, like little bear claws, onto the mat. So you're kind of pressing onto the beds of your nails through all five fingers in each hand. And then go ahead and let's focus on the right hand. We're gonna go ahead and grab onto our forearm and allow ourselves to roll a little bit deeper on our knuckles. And then we're gonna roll slightly up, even with our hips. We're gonna come off of the heels, and we're going to just come all the way to the top of our hand, and then setting the opposite hand down for support, seeing that your left shoulder is above your left wrist here, just for the consistency of alignment. See if you can touch with your right hand, the one that's the palm, the top of the hand is on the mat. Go ahead and connect your big thumb to your pinky. See if you can reach. Now connect the thumb with your ring finger. Connect your thumb with your middle finger. And connect it with your index finger. Release, and then connect back with your index finger. Now middle finger. Now ring finger. And my favorite one, with the pinky finger. All right, release it down, shake it out a little bit.
You can sit on your heels, maybe do some rounds. You can connect your hands, clasp your hands, and do some rotations from one side to the other.
All right, let's go ahead and come over to the right side. So we're going to bring the knuckles, just the nails, to the earth. All five fingertips, or however many fingers you have, I don't mean to be funny. And then we're going to bring our right hand on the mat for support. Or first of all, we're going to grab it just to give it a little bit of support here. We're going to grab the forearm with our opposite hand. Beautiful. And then go ahead and bring that palm over onto the earth. Shift your hand a little bit, so that you have your right wrist over your right shoulder, and then bringing the knuckles all the way in contact with the earth as much as possible. And then we're gonna roll onto the top of our hand. We're gonna connect our pinky finger with our thumb. Release all the way down, ring finger, release, middle finger, release, index finger, release, index again, back to middle. Ah, I'm stuck. There we go. Now ring finger, and then pinky finger, release it down. Beautiful. All right, let's go ahead and clasp our hands and like a cheerleader, and then do some rolls one more time. Beautiful. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and come on to all fours. Curl your toes under, come up to that top of a plank. Exhale up and back for your downward facing dog. And then go ahead and look up at your hands and step your left foot forward. We're gonna go to a runner's lunge. Rotate that back right thigh in toward midline. And then go ahead and come up through a crescent pose. Left leg is at a 90 degree angle. Peek down. See if you can look at your pinky toe through the inside of your knee. Draw that belly button back towards your spine. Lift the torso. And then if available to you, open your heart, your arms by your sides for goddess crescent. Go ahead and cartwheel your hands back down to the earth. Step that left foot back. Top of a plank. Exhale all the way down to a bottom of a plank as you inhale up, swoop for top, for upward facing dog. Your thighs are off of the ground, gripping them nice and tight. Bring your heels toward one another. Exhale your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Looking up at your hands, step that right foot forward. For a runner's lunge, rotate that back left thigh in toward midline as you come up. See if you can peek at your pinky toe through the inside of your right front leg. Inhale your arms up for crescent pose. And then if available to you, really opening the arms over behind you, belly towards spine, lift the chest a little bit higher. Beautiful, bring it all the way back up. Cartwheel your hands back to the mat as you step your right foot back, top of the plank. Exhale all the way down and inhale up through upward dog. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Go ahead and look up at your hands as you step both of your feet to the top of the mat. Two fists in between your hands. Bend deeply at your knees, rest your torso onto your thighs. Let go of the crown of your head as you ever so gently begin to roll yourself up vertebrae by vertebrae, back to standing, keeping your chin tucked. Allowing your head to be the last thing that comes up. Inhale your arms all the way around and up. Interlace your fingertips, allowing the index fingers to point forward. Looking down at your legs, make sure that you're about hip width distance. Inhale, lift your torso, and then go ahead and lean over to the right side. Open your top shoulder up toward the sky. Inhale, bring it back to center. And then go ahead and go over to the left side, opening your right shoulder up toward the sky. Keep pointing forward. Bring it back up. And then exhale, release your hands. Go ahead and clasp them behind you. Clasp at your elbows behind you. Open your legs a little bit wider than hip width distance. And then go ahead and rotate, roll the shoulders back behind you. Gaze is up. Very gently pick a spot of something that's not moving. And then begin to tiptoe your right leg in. And your left leg in. Keep a gaze, something that's not moving. Bring your right foot in and your left foot in, little by little. Now releasing the elbows, clasp your hands behind you, and then roll the shoulders all the way back. Begin to pull your hands down toward the earth a little bit deeper. If this is a lot of you, you can always bring your palms to your low back for support, major support here. And then lift your torso, your chest a little bit higher. Reach back behind you. Beautiful. Allow the head to maybe fall back if you feel comfortable doing so. If not yet, you can still work toward it. Very gently gaze forward. Begin to lift your gaze as you draw it back to normal or center. Looking down at your feet, go ahead and micro bend at the knees. And inhale your arms all the way around and up. Exhale, swine dive forward, lead with your heart. Allow the crown of your head to fall. And then go ahead and plant your hands onto the mat without moving them. Go ahead and extend through your arms and inhale, gaze in front of you and try to lengthen through the legs as much as possible. And then exhale, bend at your knees, chin to chest. And then exhale as you release your hips down towards your heels. Maybe some crackling is happening. Then go ahead and open your feet about mat width distance. Toes are pointing outward. Your elbows are coming inside of your knees.
palms are meeting one another, and you're going to press your knees away from you as your knees press in towards your elbows. Your palms meet one another, drawing them in towards your heart center as you lift your torso, pressing your thumbs in towards your heart, and then your pelvis is reaching for the earth. Lift your torso, reach the pelvic towards the ground floor. And then go ahead and gently let go of the grip. Palms meet one another, bringing your thumbs to your forehead for thoughts. Bringing your thumbs to your mouth for your words. And bringing your hands to your heart center one more time as you press your elbows, your knees away with your elbows and your knees into your elbows. I'm sorry, that's so confusing. Just press your knees away from midline with your arms, lifting the chest just a little bit more as the pelvis reaches toward the earth. And then go ahead and gently release. We're going to bring our hands back behind us as we come onto my favorite boat pose. Back to Barbie feet. You can keep your hands here if you're still working on your balance and core strength. Otherwise, you can bring your arms over by your sides and then go ahead and tap your right foot down one. Tap it down two. Tap it down three. Left leg one, two, and tap it one more time, three. Beautiful. Tap it down one, lengthen out. Tap it down two, lengthen out. Tap it down three, lengthen out. Beautiful. Go ahead and release it down. And now we are going to grab, let's go ahead and do some rolls really quick just to reset the spine just slightly. And now we are going to go onto a bridge pose. So bring your back all the way in connection with the earth. Bring your heels closer towards your hips. I like to have it like super duper close. And then they're usually either in alignment with my hips or just slightly outside is what I like, slightly outside. Just listen to your body, see what feels too tight, what's uncomfortable. And then we're gonna place our hands onto the earth as we inhale and lift our hips up. Take an inhale. And exhale one more time. Keeping the hips a little bit higher with each exhale. Exhale, bring it down. We're going to take that again. So go ahead and press your palms onto the earth as you inhale, rise your hips up. Pinching at your gluteus maximus. Go ahead and inhale. See if you can roll your shoulders underneath and maybe clasp your hands as you lift your hips just a little bit higher. Really sinking your heels into the mat as you exhale ever so gently, untucking the shoulders and relaxing the entire spine in connection with the earth. Now go ahead and draw your knees in towards your heart center. Give yourself a nice little tuck. and we're gonna take a couple of twists. If this is too much for you, there are two options. You can just windshield wipers back and forth and maybe choose a side, and we'll hang there for a second. Let's go over to our left side. The other one that I want to do is I want to just bring your feet together and then wrap your right leg over the left leg. Open your arms out into a T. And then go ahead and allow gravity to do the work as you allow your knees to fall over to the right side. Gazing over the left shoulder. Sorry for all the noise, you guys. Didn't know that you were coming out here. Take another inhale. Exhale, release any negativity that's been hoarding in your body and your mind. As you inhale, bring it back up to center. Let go of the legs as you wrap your now left leg on top of the right. Allow gravity to do the work here as they shift over to the left side, gazing over your right shoulder. Letting go of the legs, bringing your legs in towards your heart or your chest, opening them up, bringing your hands in between your legs and wrapping them underneath and around for happy baby. Maybe swing side to side. Maybe extending onto one leg and then the other. And then gently giving yourself one more hug, bringing your head over towards your knees. And simply releasing the legs, one. Extend, and then the other. Allowing our palms to open by our sides, relaxing the ankles and the shins, the calves and the knees. Disengaging the thighs and allowing the hips to melt into the earth, allowing our stomach and ribs to relax, letting go of the breath, allowing the shoulders to melt into the earth with the wrists. Feeling the connection of the back of the head with the earth, relax. Let go of the grip of the jaw and the muscles around your eyes. Let getting too comfortable here as you bring your breath back into your being. Wiggling out the fingertips and the toes. Stretching over above you like that morning sunrise. Rolling onto one side in the fetal pose. Taking this moment to thank yourself for showing up in the body, the maintenance it requires of you. Keeping your eyes at a soft gaze as much as possible. Or closed altogether. Go ahead and come back up to your most comfortable seated Sukhasana. As you get ready to go back into your day, I invite you to continue to join me on this live yoga on Tuesday mornings, 10 to 11 a.m. If you are not able to join, you can always catch the class later. And I want to remind you of our quote. When we recognize the divine presence everywhere, then we know that it responds to us and that there is a law of God, a law of love, forever giving of itself to us in this wholeness. Drawing your hands to your heart center, I thank you so much for letting me guide you through this practice. I'll see you next week. Namaste. If this is still rolling, thank you guys. Good job.